फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अभिव्यक्ति इंडियाज फ्यूचर क्लासरूम। इन टुडेज एपिसोड ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड वी विल सी सम टिप्स, ट्रिक्स एंड टेक्निक्स टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन टाइम, स्पीड एंड डिस्टेंस। वेलकम टू एक्सेल इन पीओ एग्जाम। हियर इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन। A boy goes to a school at a speed of 3 km per hour and returns to the village at a speed of 2 km per hour. If he takes 5 hours in all, then what is the distance between school and the village? A boy goes to a school from his village. V is a village and S is a school. And one boy goes from his village to the school in 3 km per hour speed and returns with a speed of 2 km per hour. For this journey he takes total time as 5 hours, and you have to find the total distance. So first we will assume that the total distance between village and school be x kilometer. So total distance, that is distance, is equal to x kilometer. Now since the distance is x, and in the first case the speed is 3 km per hour, then the time taken by that boy to travel from village to school will be x by 3 hours. And in a return case it will be x by 2 hours, means the time taken while going to the school and the time taken while coming back, it will be x by 3 hours and x by 2 hours respectively. Therefore the total time will be equal to x by 3 plus x by 2 is equal to 5 hours. This 5 hours is a total time that is given to us. If you solve this linear equation, you will get x is equal to 6 km, and therefore the distance between village and school is 6 km. Here is the another question, that a motor car does a journey of 10 hours. The first half at 21 km per hour and the second half at 24 km per hour, find the distance. The total time is 10 hours, that is given to you. Let the distance be x kilometer, and half of the distance will be x by 2 km. And therefore the time taken in first half plus time taken in the second half, that will be equal to total time required to reach the destination. A car starts its journey from this place and it takes 10 hours for its total journey. First half it goes with a speed of 21 km per hour, and in the second half it has a speed of 24 km per hour, and the total time taken is 10 hours. So the time taken in first half, so let the total distance be x. So first half will be x by 2, correct? And therefore time taken for the first half plus time taken in the second half, that will be what? X by 42 and x by 48, because this distance is x by 2, so it will be x by 2. And the speed is 21 km per hour. speed is 21 kilometer per hour, and therefore time will be equal to time is equal to distance upon speed. So distance is what? Distance is x by 2 upon speed is 21 kilometer per hour. So this will be what? X by 2 multiplied by 1 by 21, so it will be x by 42. Similarly, in the other half part you will get time is equal to x by 48, and this total time is given as 10 hours. And if you solve this equation, you will get it x is equal to 224 kilometer, and therefore the required distance is equal to 224 kilometer. Here is the another question. Walking 3/4 of his usual speed, a person is 10 minutes late to his office. Find his usual time to cover a distance. A man from his house to office goes with a usual speed and reaches there at a usual time. But if this usual speed is 3/4, it means 3/4 of s, then the time will be 10 minutes late, so it will be t plus 10. And since the distance is same, it is constant in both the cases, first case and second case, the speed and time will be inversely proportional. Therefore speed is inversely proportional to time, since distance is constant. And so you can take it as S1 upon S2 is equal to T2 upon T1, and you will get S upon 3/4 of S is equal to T plus 10 upon T, and further you can solve this equation to get the value of T. But just think, can you solve this in another way that is more easier than this one? Yes, it is there. The speed is what now? It is 3/4 of the original speed. 3/4 of the original speed. And the time is what? It is inversely proportional to the speed. So time should be what? It will be 4 by 3 of s. Speed is 3/4, and therefore time will be 4 by 3, and this 4 by 3 is what? 1 plus 1 by 3. And so this 1 by 3 is the additional time, that is 10 minutes. And since 1 by 3 is equal to 10 minutes, what will be complete 1? That 1 will be equal to what? 30 minutes. And therefore the usual time is what? It is 30 minutes. Friends, here we have seen this method or this way or this shortcut. In the previous episode, that is part number 2, there are two questions. Just think, can you solve these two questions by using this method? If yes, try it yourself. If you are able to solve, just give that method through comments. And if you could not, just ask me through comments. I will come to you with in the next episode with the same sums and the different method. Friends, now it is your time. Try yourself that a thief ran at a speed of 20 km per hour and a police followed a thief at a speed of 25 km per hour. After 1 hour of departure of thief, if the police started running at 7 a.m. in the morning, at what time he can catch the thief? Give your answer and your method to solve it through the comments. Here are few suggestions to you. Just click on the video, click on the link and view all this video. Thank you very much. I hope you must have enjoyed this video. If yes, like it just by clicking on the thumbs up button. Share the video with your friends and subscribe to the channel so that you will get all the updates right into your mailbox. And if you dislike it, please feel free to give the suggestions, because your suggestions and your comments are assets to us, and there is always a room for improvement. We will think on it and try to improve. Thank you very much for watching this video. Friends, you might have enjoyed this video. Then go to thumbs up button and click. Then go to share tab and share with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus and many more. And to get the updates right into your mailbox, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.